Mr. Leonard Nimoy, welcome him.
Yes, I have a very strong place in my heart for public television. I think it's a terribly important part of what television has to offer us, and an alternative kind of programming that we obviously cannot get on the networks. So it means a lot to me that stations like this continue to survive and do the good work they do.
And then you'll also visually see the item displayed on the table. All right, that's a quickie. And as you can see, you caused that bell ring.
Spend the weekend viewing and purchasing art at KVIE's Art Auction.
We're live here in the demonstration set, and this is one of my favorite parts of the Channel 6 Art Auction.
This is an incredible value when you think about it.
Okay, we're gonna close this one.
Here's a beautifully framed watercolor.
You don't want to be doing that. I want you sitting home and saying, oh, I wish I had gotten in on that.
375, let's see, 400. 400, easy.
Take a look at how you can get involved in this year's auction.
But you've got to call us first.
Every dollar you spend on art goes straight back into programming.
We are bringing the art all together in one place this weekend, and that place is right inside of your home.
Hello, and welcome to day two of the 2016 KVIE Art Auction. I'm Dee Neath, here with Cindy Sheldon, and we are pleased that you're joining us to celebrate another day of beautiful art from Northern California artists.
Today, you will also have the opportunity to bid on and buy works from featured area galleries, including the Short Center, Dadas Gallery, did I say that right?
Dadas, yes.
Auburn Old Town Gallery, award winners, and much more. And we'll be announcing one of the People's Choice winners during the 4 o'clock hour.
If you purchased art last night, you can pick it up today from noon to 5 here at the KVIE Studios, located at 2030 West El Camino Avenue in Sacramento. Be sure to bring a photo ID and a blanket to protect your art for loading into your car.
And now let's get started on day two of the 35th annual KVIE Art Auction.
KVIE is committed to the visual and performing arts through more than 500 hours of arts programming each year. From Call the Midwife to Poldark and Bob Ross to Art in the 21st Century, KVIE's commitment to the arts stays strong through your participation as a donor and art buyer. Thank you for being part of the KVIE Art Auction and for making art a part of your home today.
Stay tuned for the Short Center, coming up next on the KVIE Art Auction. Developed in 1978, this arts-based program for adults with developmental disabilities offers them a venue to develop life skills, form meaningful friendships, and become more involved with the community. View all of the art featured in this year's auction at kvie.org/artauction.
Hello and welcome to the 2016 KVIE Art Auction. I'm David Nash, and over the next half hour, you will have the opportunity to bid on and buy original works of art from the Short Center. And now, here's an overview of the art that will be up for bid during the next half hour. We'll start with item 7A, is Amoeba Man by William Haddad. This is acrylic on board measuring 22 by 16 and a half inches. Retail value is $100. Item 7B is Golden Ninja by Matt Crouch. This is acrylic on canvas, measuring 24 by 18 inches. Retail value is $200. Item 7C is Babylon by Lutuan Washington. This is mixed media, measuring 14 by 18 inches. Artist framed. Retail value is $200. Item 7D is Virgin Mary by Bob Sulin. This is mixed media, measuring 24 by 18 inches. Retail value is $200. Item 7E is Woman with a Fancy Hat by John Espugren. This is acrylic on board, measuring 24 by 20 inches. Retail value is $195. And item 7 is Cronenberg Stein by William Haddad. This is ceramic, measuring 12 by 8.5 by 5 inches. Retail value is $100. Let's get started. Our auction During this break, we're pleased to be joined by Kim Scott, an art instructor with the Short Center in Sacramento, a longtime art auction participant, and she was a juror for the 2013 KVIE art auction. Welcome, Kim, and let's get started on this first item, item 7A, Amoeba Man, and you work at the Short Center, so tell us a little bit about the artist and this beautiful piece of art.
Well, for people who watch the art auction, William Haddad, this artist is well known. He's been in a number of auctions, has donated work to a number of auctions. He does both paintings and ceramics. He's been working in the arts for over 20 years. He's quite a character. He's well known among certain circles for sure. You may have seen him out at openings yourself. This particular piece is on a piece of wood and it's acrylic. He is best known for doing his flowers, sort of these Garden of Earthly Delight paintings. Occasionally he includes people, this is one of them here, and often he's known for doing chickens and dogs and fish. And so in this piece, you can see his working style where he layers the paint up. He puts one color down and then he says, okay, it's ready to do another one. And the painting can look entirely different from one coat to the next. But what you see that's consistent about his work is all this buildup of all these different layers, and these dark outlines are very common for his work also.
And so we're looking for an opening bid right now of our value is $100. We're looking for an opening bid of $30. Make sure that you reserve one of our auction bidding operators as soon as you can, because those phones will fill up and you won't have an opportunity to bid. So we're looking for $30 opening bid, valued at $100. What a great value, and what color to this?
Right. This is the black and red is really one of his favorites. He does other color combos too. You'll notice on this particular piece, he actually painted the frame on, so it's a self-frame piece.
And this is all one piece of wood.
This is all one piece of wood, and you don't need to frame it if you don't choose to. It's already framed by the artist.
So we're looking for an opening bid of $30, valued at $100. This is an outstanding value, and you're also supporting the arts on public television. When I look at this, I see all kinds of different objects in it. It's so abstract. I see a squirrel here, okay? And I see a turtle here.
This is one of those kinds of pieces that the longer you look at it, the more it means to you. And depending on your frame of mind, it will depend on what you see in the work. You'll also see he has a signature up here. This is William. He commonly works in writing, sometimes Arabic writing, sometimes American style English. And there looks like there's numbers involved in it too. Woohoo! I personally own a lot of this man's work. I love him as an individual, and I love his work. He's developed over the years, and he's a true Sacramento treasure that we're trying to make sure he gets his name.
So $30 opening bid, that's what we're looking for right now. Let's go over to the phone bank, and Cindy and Dee are over there.
Thanks so much. And you know, if you've been a bidder in the past, you'll see we have a new phone number. You've got to write this down. It's 1-844-KVIE-ART or 1-844-584-3278. That's the number you need to write down and call right now. Right, Dee?
I want to do a quick reminder. Last night, we had people that were calling after the pieces were not available anymore. This auction moves really fast. You've got 5 to 10 minutes to get your bid in. So get online at kvie.org/art auction and preview for later on today. Let's go back to David and see another one of those great Short Center pieces.
All right, make your bids high for public television. This is item 7B. It's called Golden Ninja by Matt Crouch. And this is acrylic on canvas measuring 24 by 18 inches. Retail value is $200. We're looking for an opening bid right now. There's the phone number, 844-KVIE-ART. Make that call right now. Tell us about this piece and the artist.
Matthew Crouch is a very dedicated artist. He always carries around a sketch pad and is working constantly on that. He's also looking at references, Japanese armor, Chinese armor, movies, anime. And so you can see the influence that he's used on here, and he loves these really bright colors that pop out. That optical orange, as you can see on your screen, is just awesome. This would be great for a kid's room or for a beginning collection on outsider art. What outsider art means are people that are not academically trained, that are just motivated individuals who make art, they make what they like, they make it consistently for years, and he's one of those guys in our town.
And so don't forget to reserve an operator right now, 844-584-3278, bid high for public television. This is valued at $200. What a great value. You don't have to leave your home. You can do it at the comfort of your own telephone. And make that bid high. We're looking for your bid right now. Again, the value is $200. So this is on canvas and lots of color.
It's also self-framed. That means you don't need to pay the extra expense of getting it framed. It's painted all the way around the edge, and it's canvas, finished canvas on the edges as well. I love in this particular piece, you can see it's like some kind of a warrior. There's a that pink sky is awesome. And then you can see he's got the bulging muscles, which is a favorite of Matt's, to put the bulging muscles and all that armor on there and those silver eyes.
So there's the phone number, 844-584-3278. Reserve your operator right now and make sure you have an opportunity to bid high on these items that we are looking at this half hour. And our bid rate, we're looking for an opening bid right now. Value at $200. We would like to open this bid at $50. So can we hear from you right now at $50 to open this bid up, valued at $200. And this is a, I mean, this you say this would look good in a kid's room, especially if they like their ninja type stuff.
Sure, or if you're starting an outside collection or you already have an outsider collection. A lot of people just collect artists from the short centers. There are three different short centers. All the works we're looking at today are from Short Center North. You can actually see more of the works and hear interviews with the artists at ddsoarts.org. That can give you even more of a sense of what's going on, the amazing things that are going on there, and the fantastic, fascinating artists.
Looking for a $50 opening bid valued at $200, 844-584-3278. Let's go over to Rob at the phone bank.
You guys are doing great, and I'm Rob Stewart. We're here live at the KVIE Art Studio today, the Art Studio. We're the largest studio in Northern California, and today we are your front row seat to the arts. We know it's a beautiful day outside, okay? We know there's a lot going on, but this is the time to stay near to your television or if you're watching online anywhere in America and to get involved in keeping the arts alive on KVIE Public Television. All of the art that we have here today has been completely donated 100% to KVIE to keep our arts and our mission alive. We are your source for content. We are your source for unbiased news. This is the place that you turn to, the number one respected station in news. And this weekend, we're pleased to be your number one station for the arts. As I said, this weekend alone, we're the largest art gallery in Northern California. I find that so cool, with more than 280 pieces of art in the collection. Dee Neath, our art curator who is over there, she had to go through more than 600 pieces, and that was a blessing to be able to do that. And she selected the 284 just for you. Let's head back across the studio with more beautiful art from the Short Center.
Okay, and here is item 7C. It's Babylon by Latuan Washington. This is mixed media measuring 14 by 18 inches, artist framed, and the retail value is $200. We're looking for a starting bid of $60, 844-KVIE Art. Make that call right now. Kim, tell us about this piece.
I love the work of many of the artists at the Short Center. Latuan happens to be one of my favorite. She's a long-term artist. She's been working for over 10 years. These are Prismacolor and felt pen. The black is felt pen and the rest is Prismacolor. She has a tendency to choose biblical or historical stories from different cultures to use in her work, to illustrate in her work. If you look closely, they have great coverage here in high def. You see this multi-headed cat, it looks like, eating this person or tearing their clothes off, it looks like. Latuan, it says, executing Babylonian the Great. So that's what her topic is about. She has a very distinctive style. She scrubs that pencil in until it shines. It's so saturated, the color, and her color sense is awesome.
So looking for a $60 bid, 844-KVIE-ART. Make sure that you get your person on the phone to bid for you and reserve that operator as soon as you can. Again, we're looking for a $60 opening bid, a $200 retail value. This comes from one of the students at the Short Center. You've been there since 1978. Tell us a little bit about the Short Center.
The Short Center is a day program for adults with developmental disabilities, and it's one of the main employers of artists in the Sacramento area. And then there's also all the artists that are there as clients as well. And so it's a closely guarded secret that it's one of the greatest art centers in the Sacramento area.
Okay, so we're looking for an opening bid of $60, a $200 retail value. 584-3278 is the phone number. That's 844-584-3278.
I think this piece is so refined, it could go in any collection. If you have a folk collection or an outsider collection, it'd be a gem in that. It's also a good size to go anywhere in your home. It pops the color out, and it's very refined looking at the same time.
And I love the way it was matted and how it's framed. It really makes the art pop. Mm-hmm. We're going to go over to Cindy and Dee at the phone bank to get an update.
We've got a 7A. We've got a bid on that. We're waiting on bids on the other work. I really wanted to say a little bit about the Short Center. 30 years ago, when I started my gallery, it was one of the first group of artists I've shown. It was also one of the first pieces I bought when I was 20. The piece is still an important part of my collection. A well-rounded collection should include all kinds of art. That includes outsider art, naive art, you know, maybe ethnic art. You want to really broaden your collection, and this is the way to do it. These are professional artists. They work very hard at what they do. They're taught all the latest techniques. They're given the best materials, and these pieces are just fun, fun, fun. Mine is a piece called The Gossipers, and it's been in my kitchen for 30 years, and I enjoy it every day. But you can't do it unless you call. So let's go back out and look at the Virgin Mary.
Okay, item 7D is Virgin Mary by Bob Sulin. This is mixed media, measuring 24 by 18 inches. Retail value is $200. Looking for an opening bid of $60. Tell us about this piece of art, Kim.
Bob Sulin has donated art a couple of times to the KVIE art auction in the past, so some of you may be familiar with his work. He likes to take popular or classic imagery and renders it in his own style. He's a pretty well-known guy. He's shown in New York. He has his work in the Smithsonian. He's been in art shows all over the place and in big collections all over the place too, as well as locally. This particular piece it's like a nice symmetrical piece. I love the gold paint in the background and the stars that pop out, and it looks like, I don't know if those are drapes or if it's a sun and a moon or what it is, but I love the symmetry in it. And if you look close down here, the Virgin Mary is holding in her cape all the beautiful, you know, these beautiful little figures that are praying to her. It's a contemporary religious piece, you know, if that might mean something to you. Or just the art quality itself. It's based on an older painting.
So 844-584, you can see it on the screen, 844-584-3278 or 844-KVIE-ART. Make sure you reserve your operator to bid for you, and make sure you reserve that because something may come up and the phones may be busy and you won't be able to get through. So reserve your operator right now, looking for a first bid, an opening bid of just $60. This is valued at $200. I spend a lot of time in Ethiopia and visit the Orthodox churches mm-hmm. there. Mm-hmm. And you see these big, beautiful icons. Mm-hmm. This is a very contemporary icon, and it's beautiful. And so $60 opening bid, very contemporary, very beautiful.
And once again, it's self-framed. The artist has painted clear around on the finished canvas mm-hmm. edges on it, so you don't have to invest in a frame unless it would look awesome with a big, gaudy gold frame on it, though. That's
yeah.
probably what I
would
like
do. It just the way it
yeah.
is. $60 opening bid is what we're looking for, 844-584-3278. Rob's over at the phone bank.
Yeah, and I love this piece. This is Golden Ninja. It is so much fun, and all of these pieces are done from the Short Center, our friends who are differently abled. and they are showing you their talents here today in such a fun and inspiring way. Detail us about this piece.
I love this piece because I'm a big cartoon anime fan. Kind of reminds me of Wolverine a little bit. What an inspiration to have your own superhero in your kitchen or in your office, somebody to get you up and inspired in the mornings. The other thing I love about this piece is these guys use quality materials. This is a great canvas. You know, they provide their students, they're professional artists, they provide them with professional materials.
You know, I have to say, I've had the privilege of meeting several of the people who go to the Short Center, and many of them cannot share their story with you verbally, but they certainly can through art. And this is such an expression from the people who go to the Short Center. I have a piece in my kitchen that I got several years ago. It's functional art. There's a piece coming up in this half hour of that as well.
It's good to have a piece of outsider art. Like I said, round out your collection. And you can only do that by calling 1-844-584-3278. Get online at kvie.org and see what's coming up later on. So meanwhile, let's go back. I love this red hat piece.
I do too. It's cute.
I do too. This is item 7E. It's a Woman with Fancy Hat by John Espergren. This is acrylic on board, measuring 24 by 20 inches, retail value $195, and we're looking for an opening bid of $55 on this item. Talking about color.
I love this piece. John Espergren is one of the artists that's worked the longest at the Short Center North. He's extremely dedicated to the point that you have to make sure he doesn't do a painting on somebody else's painting because he's just moving right along, you know. This particular piece, he's also looking at an art historical classic Renaissance painting, era painting, but he's put his own stamp on it. What he uses quite often is he uses lettering. He uses them as a design element, though. You can't really quite read what it says, but you know that it's writing, and that's
kind of like an eye chart in a way.
It's interesting to him as a shape, so he's copying shapes rather than words. He uses his visual language. I love the contemporary colors he's used on here. They really pop out. Once again, it kind of has that golden background you might see on an old portrait of a fancy lady with a red hat.
What room in a home, where do you picture this?
You know, I could see this in any room. I definitely could see it in a living room or dining room, maybe in a cluster. Or if you have a small wall space, this would go great in a hallway or in a small wall space as well. This is what you call a cabinet painting. It's a piece that's made to go in a person's home. It's just the right size to go in a person's home. And if you have someplace that needs to be brightened up, lit up, this will do it for you. It'll really draw the eye. If you already have these colors in your house, it's awesome, but if you don't, it'll liven things up. Any dark corner, it'll liven up.
So this is from the Short Center, and all the funding from this art auction supports the arts here on public television, KVIE. So bid high, your dollars go to something tremendous in our community. And so support us, $55 is our opening bid, $195 is the retail value, 844-584-3278. Reserve your operator right now. Go over to your telephone and make that call.
Also, this man, he's difficult to understand. His verbal communication is difficult to understand. You can hear an interview with him at ddsoarts.org that's fascinating, and he'll reveal more about himself if you want to check that out. But buy this first, and then you can find out more about it later.
All right, $55 retail value. Let's go over to Dee at the phone bank.
I am standing in the phone bank with Bob Sullen's Virgin Mary. This is not your grandma's Madonna. This is a great modern Madonna for you to put in your home. I come from a Catholic family, and we've always had one in the house, but I love this one. It's poppy, it's contemporary. She kind of makes you smile a little bit, but you can only get her if you call 1-844-584-3278. I have a current bid on this piece of $60, and it's a $200 value. You've got about 4 or 5 minutes to make that call and bring her home for the holidays. Let's go back out to you guys.
All right, Dee, thanks. Again, we're at $195 retail value. value. $55 is what we're looking for. This is a great item to start a collection for your child or perhaps your grandchildren to start an art collection in your home. And so bid high on this. $55 is our opening bid. The $195 is the retail value. Tell us more about this beautiful piece of art.
This man is definitely, what is the definition of an artist? It's somebody who's interested in the arts and takes the time to do it every single day. This is this guy right here. It's what he has to contribute to the Sacramento Valley's cultural scene. Mm-hmm. I really appreciate his work. It's elegant. It's also got a little sense of humor there. There's sort of a grandness about his work. Even though it has some stylistic choices that somebody might attribute to a child, he is not a child, he's an adult. These are the stylistic choices he's improved on over the years. This piece is one of my favorite pieces of his. This face, I love those eyebrows.
So $55 high bid right now. We're looking for your high bid. Go over to your phone and make that call. Okay, so our next bid is, next item is 7F. It's the Cronenberg Stein by William Houdad. This is ceramic, measuring 12 by 8.5 by 5 inches. Its retail value is $100. This is gonna go fast. This one's gonna go really fast, okay?
Woohoo!
So tell us about how, this is beautiful, okay?
So this is the
first. This is a bell ringer, by the way.
Yeah, the first artist that we saw, William Haddad, this is the same artist, his sculptural work. He's become quite collectible, especially his ceramic works. And you can see why with this piece. It's heavily fantasy-oriented. Look at that stein. Can you imagine filling that up with beer and having a, I don't think so, but. This would be perfect as if you have a collection of teapots or pitchers or something like that. It'd be fat or signs.
It's really 3D because it has objects protruding from it, but also things engraved in it.
The shape is interesting. The surface has been inscribed with a sharp object. There's also been these little blobs added to it, which I love. It's like Braille almost. And he has his.
Can we keep going that way then?
Yeah, okay. Sure, go that way. You can see it's like the garden scene that he does quite often in his work with all those layers of interesting color, and it's very jewel-like. It's one of the nicest pieces I've seen come out of his in the last couple of years.
And Rob says he has one of his pieces in his kitchen that he keeps all of his kitchen utensils in.
Yeah, I have three of his bowls myself. I love the drippy jewel-like glazes. It almost looks like the Spanish majolica.
How about some color? How about some color in your kitchen?
Also, if you could see the inside is all glazed with blue with some dribbles down of these orange colors at the top. It's beautiful inside as well as out. With his work, if you light it from above, if you're putting it on a pedestal or something in your house, it just glows with the colors coming from that are on the inside.
Absolutely beautiful. Make your bid high right now at 844-584-3278. Let's go over to Cindy at the phone bank.
Thanks so much, David. We really need a bid on Babylon. You know, we've gotten bids on every piece in this particular set except for Babylon, and we really need to close this out with a bid. The donor value of this is $200. If you're not familiar with the Short Center, they've been donating every single year. They take classes, our classes, 6 hours a day, every day. These are wonderful people, wonderful artists. So you'd not only be doing something great for Channel 6 and yourself, but also the Short Center. The number is right there on your screen. It's 1-844-KVIE-ART or 844-584-3278. Now back to David.
I just love this engraving of a flower right here. And William Haddad has two pieces in our collection during this art auction. Mm-hmm. This is his 3D piece. Mm-hmm. Also has a 2D piece.
Right. This is the second year that he has donated two pieces to our auction. And it would really be awesome to actually have a painting of his on the wall with a sculpture in front of it to give the full effect of what he's working on. He also does some sculptural pieces of animals. He does these he's famous also for doing these little wall plaques that end up in people people's gardens on the fence, which are really little jewels. But this is really a masterwork for him. The scale is quite large, and he's got lots of layers with something that looks like calligraphy. He does use a lot of Arabic writing in his work as well, and I think he has his initials on here. Usually he has somewhere his initials on the pieces. In fact, I think I can find it over here. It's the blue.
844-584-3278, bid high for the arts here on public television.
This is in blue. It's a hard to read, but it's a W and A. That's his signature, which he incorporates into almost everything.
Awesome. Okay, bid high, reserve your operator right now, and go over to your telephone. Stay tuned because there's more art coming up in the next half hour in the KVIE Art Auction.
Bidding on items in the art auction is quick and easy to do. First, explore the collection online at kvie.org/art auction. Or keep your television tuned to KVIE. When a piece of art catches your eye, call 1-844-KVIE-ART and a volunteer will assist you. KVIE accepts all major credit cards for your art purchase, and a member of our accounting team will confirm your payment within 5 minutes of item sale. Thank you for being part of the KVIE Art Auction and for making art a part of your home today.
Stay tuned for Contemporary Classics, coming up next on the KVIE Art Auction. Juried by Brenda Louie, this category features abstract and non-objective works in all media. View all of the art featured in this year's auction at kvie.org/art auction.
Hello again, I'm David Nash, and we're back for another half hour of auction excitement. And in this half hour, we will be featuring contemporary classic works. And now here's an overview of the art that will be up for bid during the next half hour. We're gonna start with item 8A. It's Plague of Convenience, number 5, by John Stuart Berger. This is acrylic on canvas, measuring 24 by 26 inches. Retail value is $600. Item 8B is There Sure Is a Lot to Say and Think About by Jared Konopitsky. And this is acrylic on canvas, measuring 16 by 20 inches. Retail value $150. Item 8C is Mirage Utwa by Chris Boda. This is acrylic on board, measuring 20 by 16 inches, artist framed, retail value is $600. Item 8D is Free Fall by June Daskalakis. This is mixed media, measuring 16 by 12 inches, retail value is $350. Item 8E is Eiffel by Matthew Glazer. This is ceramic, measuring 24 by 11 by 8 inches, retail value $300. Item 8F is White Flowers by Aparna Jitudni. This is sculpture, measuring 42 by 20 by 24 inches, retail value is $280. Let's get started on this. Kim Scott's here. And during this break, we're once again pleased to have Kim join us, a local artist and a previous art auction juror. Thank you once again, Kim, for helping us here at the KVIE 35th anniversary art auction. Okay,
so
let's
happy to be here.
Talk about this piece, item 8A, Plague of Convenience by John Stuart Berger, 24 by 26 inches, retail value $600, looking for an opening bid of $180.
John Berger is a well-known artist in the Sacramento area, and just by the by, he's the art director of the Short Center North, so he's kind of ties into that last group of paintings that you saw in the last half hour. He makes, they're like mutated organisms. That's his main thing. Mm. So there's nothing that looks like it's entirely just a rat or a bat. It's
something or a mouse.
Or a mouse, or a snake, or the tongue of a bat.
Yeah.
So they're kind of surrealistic, but he uses these extremely rich colors. The background colors are something you might see in those Hudson River Valley paintings of the Sacramento Valley from years ago.
Doesn't need to be framed. It's wrapped around.
Doesn't need to be framed.
Canvas.
He's done another couple of really big productions in Sacramento, including a 200-foot-long mural on L Street between 16th and 18th Street about. And also he was in the Art of Dumpsters, which is on Power Inn Road. Driving down there, you might have seen it sitting there, a huge piece painted on a dumpster. He's been painting for many years. He has an education in printmaking and painting. Went to Sac State, among other places. Love his work. I've shown with him myself a number of times. He's a great guy and is very prolific. He's shown all over the place, all over the United States. He's well known.
And very, I mean, it's the beady eye, the whisk, check the whiskers out here.
Right. It's funny because it has, I wouldn't say cartoony, but it's like an exaggerated kind of like cartoons. Mm-hmm. But he's got these fantastic, brilliant blends going on. That sky is so cool with all the little bubbles in it. And it really tells a story. What is the story? It's maybe a little frightening.
Maybe so.
Yep.
So it's a very detailed, lots of mm-hmm. these little bubbles. We're looking for an opening bid of $180. $600 is the retail on this. Phone number 844-584-3278. Make your high bid and support the arts on public television. Make sure you reserve your operator to do your bidding for you, because if all the phones get busy, there's no way that you can bid. So make sure you reserve your operator. If there's any of these pieces that you saw in our intro that you want to bid for, make sure you reserve your operator right now.
He is one of the artists that's involved in a larger arts community in California, a movement that really started in California, a pop surrealist movement. So that involves a lot of really great blending, but then in a real exaggeration with the characters as well. It's telling a story. A lot of pop surrealism has a narration of some kind, and even though it may not be totally clear, the longer you look at it, your mind will fill in the blanks and tell you what's going on there.
Okay, Kim, we're going to go over to the phone bank with Cindy real quick, okay? Cindy?
You know, I want to remind you, this is the 35th anniversary for the KVIE Art Auction. This happens once a year. I say this once a year. It's a three-day auction. This is day two. Tomorrow, after that, it's gone. And you have to wait another full year for this auction. This is the best time of the year here at KVIE Studios. The number is on your screen, 1-844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART, which is a brand new number than what we've used in the past. So I hope you call right now. David?
Okay, item 8B is There Sure Is a Lot to Say and Think About by Jared Konopitsky. This is acrylic on canvas measuring 16 by 20 inches. Retail value is $150. And we're looking for your opening bid right now. Go over to your telephone, 844-KVIE-ART. That's 844-584-3278. Tell us about this amazing piece of art.
Jared is a local artist who has shown internationally and nationally. He's shown at the Crocker. He's shown at the Smithsonian. He's had work in the New Yorker magazine. He really gets his work out there. And he's an extremely nice guy, which is great. And you can see that in his work.
Happy.
This particular piece, he told me that he was listening to the birds in the tree outside of his house and how they were talking back and forth to each other and chatting with each other. And he sort of imagined them as, it was like a social network for birds. The tree was a social network for birds.
They were tweeting.
Yes. Yeah, they were tweeting. He says, I know it's silly, but that's exactly what I thought. And he always likes to bring something humorous into his work and sort of darling in his work. It's super easy to look at, but yet there's like a little edge with that color, the way he blends. It looks like maybe a spray paint blend going on there.
So what do you think this bird's thinking? What's your interpretation?
Looks like he's thinking about leaves to me.
And I was thinking the same thing, that it's the end of winter. It's enough already with winter. The tree doesn't have any leaves on it. This bird is willing
leaves onto the tree, and I think it's starting to work here. This is a happy picture, happy piece of art. And where do you see this going in someone's home?
This could go in any corner you want to brighten up. It could be in any room. I mean, I'd love it in my kitchen. He has a funny narrative here. He talks about trees are the social media of the bird world. This is a rare, short-spined, orange-breasted tiger bird. This is the only one known to man. The colors are based on the only range of color this particular bird can see. So he has a whole deeper story going on here about this character, which I love to hear about those.
So basically this bird's extinct.
Well, it's
the last one.
There's only one.
Right.
I think there probably only ever was one.
Right. Yeah, very. So I see it in a child's room because it's got so much color to it.
It'd be very pleasing.
Hey, we're looking for your bid. The high bid right now is $100, and we're looking, the retail is $150. So why don't we push that up a little bit higher, bid high for public television and the arts on television. Let's go back over to Rob and Dee.
We are here with one of John Berger's pieces. John Berger is one of my favorite artists. He started 30 years ago. He's a master. He started 30 years ago when I was first starting at Michael Himovitz Gallery.
Really?
He was one of Michael's first artists. He's very popular and highly collected in Sacramento. It's a $600 piece. I need a $180 opening bid.
It's shocking to me that there's no starting bid on this. By the way, the last two pieces prior to this piece tripled their value. You can sneak in and get this piece by getting on the phone. It closes in like 5 minutes. I mean, there's a way you can sneak in and take these pieces if you do it methodically.
And either Rob or I would love to have this.
Yes, we would,
under
but we're not allowed to say that. But I will tell you that I know John Stewart Berger. He's a wonderful man. He's highly collected. I've seen him in many homes throughout the region. And his pieces are conversation pieces, which I love, because everybody that I know that has stood around one of his pieces sees something different.
They're very narrative. Each one is a complete little story.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's go back to David.
Okay, item 8C is Mirage Outoi by Chris Botta. This is acrylic on board measuring 20 by 16 inches. It's artist framed. And the retail value is $600. And we're looking for an opening bid of $180. Make your bid high for public television and tell us about this. It's extraordinary, busy. It's got lots to look at. And I'm seeing things in here, okay?
Yeah, Chris says that this—
Chris signed it right here, too.
He's right in the middle, I love that. And his last name is over
Botta,
to the side.
Right, right.
There's lots going on here. There are three people in here, as well as a baseball and a bunch of insects and a bunch of other stuff going on. He said it's a self-portrait, so I don't know. Which one do you think it's him? This one?
I'm not sure. I'm not kidding you. I looked at this from a distance. That's Bob Marley?
Oh, yeah. Well, that's cool. And I was looking at the name Mirage Outoi. And I thought, what is that? And I looked up Outoi, and there was no word in the language Outoi. And I'm thinking, what does that mean, mirage? And then I thought, menage Outoi. It's a little joke there, okay?
Uh-huh.
Which was pretty funny when I found out, because I'd done all this research trying to figure it out. So what he does, it
Chris
looks
is a
like,
baseball fan.
Yeah. So there's also this frame has been personalized. There's all this scratching and burning on this frame, which is pretty cool with plants and stuff. He's known for these very busy, layered paintings. I think you would never really get tired of this painting. It has so much going on. Figurative's always really nice, too, and the colors are great. He's done a lot of layering here, which is great, and I just want to look at it for a long time. That's what I want to do. He's a well-known artist in town. I don't know if I mentioned this, this is from the Cowgirl series, and he's affiliated with E Street Gallery. He's been showing in Sacramento for a long time.
Beautiful piece. Opening bid is $180. Phones are ringing. That's exciting. Let's get into a bidding war over this beautiful item. We're looking for a $180 starting bid, retail value, Mirage Outoi. It is a $600 retail. Notice, too, the frame was self-made and engraved. So there's Chris's name. There's the baseball down here, and lots of flowers and ferns and all kinds of beautiful things that really brings out this beautiful this art, and it's got so much texture to it also.
It does. It's the it's very I want to touch it. I'm not going to touch it, but you just feel like you could almost feel, you know, there's another layer to it the way it would feel. If you're thinking about collecting starting a collection of Sacramento artists, he would be a very fundamental great artist to start with. And if you already have a collection, you don't have something of Chris's, now's the time. The price is so excellent, and it's helping KVIE with their art.
Got the butterflies, the dragonflies, beautiful piece of art, the
daisy.
Beautiful daisy right there. Mm-hmm. Okay, $180. Let's get into a bidding war over this item. $600 retail value. Let's go back over to the phone bank and see how we're doing.
We're here with Jared Konopinski's piece. He is one of my favorite artists. What I love about this piece, his wife is expecting their first baby.
Aww.
So this is all about spring and birth and being excited. He does the most fun work, and this would be a perfect piece to welcome a new collector into your home.
You know, this is almost a bell ringer, so you've got to call right now. The telephone number is 1-844-584-3278, or if it's easier, 1-844-KVIE-ART. You've got to call right now and bid on this great piece. I see this in a child's room.
I know,
because
congratulations on the baby.
Because the name of it is called There Sure Is a Lot to Say and Think About. What a fabulous message to give your little
ones. And what a great way to support PBS. When the artist gives us the piece, they want us to get that $150. So let's go back out to David and Kim.
Okay, make sure you reserve your operator right now and bid high for public television and the arts on television here in the Sacramento region. Here's item 8D. It's Free Fall by June Daskalakis. And this is mixed media measuring 16 by 12 inches. Retail value is $350. We're looking for a high bid, an opening bid of $150. This is a unique piece. You've got a lot to tell us about on this one, Kim.
Yeah. Well, June has told us that this relates to the Alfred Hitchcock movie, The Birds.
Sure.
That was made in 1963, and this tells a story about what happens to those birds after they leave the movie. And this shows them coming in on a concrete environment. It looks like there's some other kinds of birds in here, too.
It's like a pelican?
Lots of other different kinds of birds. And so she likes to tell a story. She puts this is collage. There's painting in the background, and it looks like a collage and maybe some ink work or something on there
as well. A postcard that says to R.A. Hitchcock, Universal Studios, Los Angeles, California. And then another postcard to Mr. Hitchcock that says, see, they... D in Free Fall Now, please advise. They are in Free Fall Now, please advise. Now, tell us about, how was this done? I mean, it's so detailed.
I'm guessing that she printed out these. The birds are probably all printed out on paper. They look like they also have been watercolored by hand. Mm-hmm. And so it's a mixed media. That's what they would call a mixed media. I love the crow up on this one, too. I'm not sure that you can see. Oh, well, you can see it in your photograph on the TV there. But she's actually wrapped those birds around the side.
Oh,
so
yeah.
The frame also contains more of the story, where the birds are entering into the picture plane from the frame sides. So I would want to, yeah, I have a tendency looking at this, I just want to make up a story in my mind about it. And her giving us the birds as a starting point, ooh.
$350 opening bid. We're currently at $210. 844-584-3278. Make your call right now and reserve your operator to bid for you. We've got a little bidding war going on for this unique piece.
She says in her notes, amidst the chaos, a cry for help in the postcard. So That's like the message, like, what are we going to do now, right?
So this is the arts, and the arts on public television is unique, and KVIE is a unique television station here in the Central Valley, and we are asking you for your support by bidding high. Not only are you going to take a beautiful piece of art home and hang it in your home or use it as a gift, but you're also going to be supporting public television and the arts here on KVIE. So bid high right now. Get into a bidding war over this one. We're currently at $225. Our retail value is at $350. We'd like to push that up to $250 right now at 844-584-3278, supporting the arts here on public television. And purchasing unique art. This is not a copy. You'll never find anything like this. This is a one of a kind.
June finds discarded imagery from newspapers, from books, and different places. And then she starts playing around with them, and they tell the story. She doesn't go into this knowing exactly what it's going to look like when she's through. She plays with it, sets up, you know, adds different parts to it until it tells a story from its own side.
Okay, we're at 225. Let's hear 250 over to Cindy at the phone bank.
You know, this Chris Botta piece definitely has my vote for the best title. It's called Mirage à Trois, and it is by, as I said, Chris Botta is one of the most popular artists in Sacramento. This value is $600 on this piece. We are have yet to receive a bid. All we need is a starting bid of $180, and then you'll be hanging, actually this will be hanging in your home, a $600 worth piece of beautiful art. And look at the frame on this. It's hand-carved. It's just... it's unique. It's one of a kind. All the money goes to KVIE Channel 6. The number's on your screen, 1-844-584-3278. We need to call you to call right now. We don't want to send this out without a bid. Now let's go back to David.
Okay, item 8E is Eiffel by Matthew Glazer. This is ceramic, measuring 24 by 11 by 8 inches, retail value $300. Kim Scott is here to tell us a little bit about this beautiful piece of ceramic.
Matthew uses torn pieces of rolled out clay to build these forms. And you can kind of see how it's a patchwork of different shapes, irregular shapes. There's some areas that look like they've been cut with a knife or something like that. But and then he incises them, puts them together, and then glazes them. And he doesn't start with an idea, particularly what the vessel is going to be, until he continues the work on it.
And then where's the color come in?
After, well, with the clay, you let it dry, then you give it a first fire, and then you glaze it and you fire it again. And so that's probably what he did with this. And he's affiliated with Panama Pottery, if anybody's heard about that. It's a great center for ceramics in Sacramento. And he has said that this ended up being a tower to go in a modern city. So he's using this like a maquette. So you can imagine a piece that would be huge like this, you know, stories and stories tall in his city.
Interesting. Opening bid is, we're at a high bid of $90 right now. The retail value is $300, 844-584-3278. Make sure that you have already reserved your operator. Let's get into a bidding war over this. Let's push that up to $125. Retail value is $300. Do I hear $125 for the arts here on public television?
What he has said in his statement is that the piece may be random when he's putting the clay together, and he uses the colored glazes to help brings the pieces together so it looks like it all belongs together. So you can see he's used the same color palette with the green, brown, orange, and blue are the main color palettes, as well as the natural color of the clay coming through a clear glaze.
And the layers make it 3D, and what's interesting, I'm looking at something you may not be able to pick up on television, but maybe you can. You can actually see shadows under some of these layers, which really bring the color out and the layers, the complexity of this beautiful piece of art.
And you can't see the back, but the back's as interesting as the front. It's it's a 360 degree piece.
I would turn it for you, but we don't want any accidents.
A hole in the top. It's almost like a chimney or a geyser or something like that, like a natural form. To me, it looks like it's halfway between a natural form of worn down rock formations that are worn down through the years and man-made. It's like a real combination. And then all the shapes that he has on here, like scratches, and he looks like he's put objects on there like sponges that give it more texture. It's a beautiful thing, and the glaze is really beautiful on it.
$300 is the retail on this item. We're looking right now, we're at $90, looking for $125. Let's push that up to $125. You're going to take a beautiful piece of art home. This would look great in a den or a living room, or maybe on some kind of a hutch. This is a gorgeous piece, a unique piece, and you're only a one of a kind.
Yeah.
And you're going to be able to take this home and also at the same time know that you're doing your part supporting the arts here at public television. Let's go back over to the phone bank.
Okay, thank you so much. We are going to thank our phone bank, which is the Five Cities Democratic Club and the California Highway Patrol. Everybody, thank you so much for giving us your Saturday afternoon. Voila, there you have. Oh, just smacked it. They even get smacked in the head, and they're so sweet about it. Listen. Got lots of calls here today. We've had the phones in action. We're looking for, you okay?
I'm good.
Okay.
He's happy.
We're looking for, I'm sorry, I'm still thrown.
We just got a bid on Mirage.
Cindy, why
Trois.
Should people jump in and call right now? By the way, we just got a Mirage a Trois for just, 180.
And right now we're hoping a bid comes in on White Flowers. I said it before, we only do this once a year. After tomorrow, that's it. This is the live art auction. This is not tape. This is not a reel. We're coming to you live. If you see a piece you like, you need to call immediately the number on your screen so you can be hanging that piece on your wall tonight.
And pickup is actually open now. So pickup is open now from noon until 5, so you literally could be shopping from your home or online. We'll ship anywhere in the country.
Let's go back to David.
Okay, item 8F is White Flowers by Aparna Jituni. This is sculpture measuring 42 by 20 by 24 inches. Retail value is $280. We're looking for an opening bid of $75. 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART is the phone number to reserve your operator to bid high for some of the beautiful works that we're seeing today. Kim, tell us about this piece.
Aparna, this is an example of something that's very popular right now called the makers movement. Hmm. And before there were plastic flowers, there were silk flowers. Before that, there were handmade silk flowers. Mm-hmm. So these are all handmade by a person.
Paper?
Uh-huh. This looks like it's paper and wood. There may be some other, I'm not sure. That's the artist could tell you, but it looks like predominantly paper. And she is known for making these beautiful centerpieces for your home that will last and last and last. They're also like biodegradable and stuff. You know, they're gonna last for a long time. She also does ornamentation like hair flowers out of fabric I've seen before.
And she's got these on a very gnarly, I'll call it, piece of manzanilla. Mm-hmm. And it's one of those, I just wanna touch it.
Don't you touch it. I know what you mean. It's beautiful. You can bring springtime into your house and it'll just stay springtime forever with this. It's wonderful. It's elegant. The tones that she's used will go with any kind of environment. It doesn't matter what the style your home is. It would look beautiful in whatever container you would have. I like it. She shows at the Archival Framing Art Gallery as well. You can see you may have seen other examples of her work there in the past.
Yeah, beautiful centerpiece in your home, and what a great statement this would make in your home. We're at $75 is our high bid right now. Retail is $280. We would love to push this up in $25 increments. Let's hear $100. Make that call. Let's get a little bidding war going for this one. Let's go over to Rob at the phone bank, see how we're doing.
Okay, well, we're checking in over here with this beautiful piece, Eiffel, by Matthew Glazier, and it is for $300. We have an opening bid of $90. This piece is almost as half as tall as I am. It is a large piece. It's Eiffel, and it's an interpretive piece. I'll just say that. The phone number is 1-844-584-3278. The easy way to remember it is 1-844-KVIE-ART. Eiffel is at $90 right now. It is a ceramic, and the colors in it are exquisite, the blues and the oranges. And we will now go back over to the rest of the group.
Okay, item 8F, White Flowers, retail value $280. We're at $75, trying to push that up to $125 increments. Tell us more about this piece.
Every single one of these flowers is made by hand. They're all cut out by hand and joined together. And she's really incorporated it beautifully onto this manzanita. And we all are familiar with Manzanita in the area here in the Central Valley.
Which is a unique piece in itself. It's got the dark portions and the very light portions.
And each one of these flowers, it's not all just the same kind of paper. There's a variety of different kind of papers. So when you get up close, you can see some of them are kind of translucent. Some of them are more opaque. She's curled them to a certain degree to imitate the shape of a petal in a flower. And then she's put these little tiny, they look like maybe bamboo, I'm not sure, pieces that have been stained as the stamen inside the center of the flower. They're lovely, and I could definitely see how this could translate into fabric as well.
I could see how it could translate into a conversation piece in a home, right? In the living room,
your
on the
entryway,
right.
or at an office as well. It would be really a beautiful statement to make.
Okay, trying to push this up to $100, $25 increments, $280 retail value, 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART. Stay tuned because there's more art coming up in the next half hour in the KVIE Art Auction. Thank you.
KVIE is committed to the visual and performing arts through more than 500 hours of arts programming each year. From Call the Midwife to Paul Dark and Bob Ross to Art in the 21st Century, KVIE's commitment to the arts stays strong through your participation as a donor and art buyer. Thank you for being part of the KVIE Art Auction and for making art a part of your home today.
Stay tuned for Still Life and Landscapes, coming up next on the KVIE Art Auction. Juried by Carrie Kelly, this category features still life and non-California landscapes in all media. View all of the art featured in this year's auction at kvie.org/art auction.
Hello and welcome to the 2016 KVIE Art Auction. I'm Kelly Rains, and over the next hour you will have the opportunity to bid on and buy original works of art graciously donated by Northern California artists and featured in the Still Life and Landscapes category. And now here's an overview of the art that will be up for bid during the next half hour. Item 9A is Tulips and Fruit by Patricia Toole McHugh. This is watercolor measuring 16 by 24 with a retail value of $450. Item 9B is Poppy by Emily Elders. This is relief print measuring 16 by 20 with a retail value of $350. Item 9C is Spring Thaw by Alan Shannon. This is acrylic on canvas measuring 24 by 30. It has a retail value of $600. Item 9D is Water Lily Solitude by Teresa Steinbeck Garcia. This is watercolor measuring 17 by 24 with a retail value of $560. Item 9E is Mighty Nature by Carol Hawkins. This is mixed media measuring 12 by 12. It has a retail value of $550. And item 9F is Dark Matter by Marcia Ballard. This is acrylic on paper measuring 22 by 28. It has a retail value of $500. During this break, we are pleased to be joined by Mary Ellen Lane, a longtime volunteer at the station, an award-winning mosaic artist with a piece in this year's collection, and our art expert to talk about this hour's Still Life and Landscapes collection. Welcome, Mary Ellen.
Thank you, Kelly. Great to be here.
It's an honor to be with you.
Thank you.
So our first piece is item 9A, Tulips and Fruit, and tulips are my favorite flower. What can you tell us about these tulips?
Patricia Toole McHugh, and she was a professor at Sac City for a number of years, and they're celebrating their 100th anniversary this year. But this piece is about fauvism to me, it feels like. It's very bright, very colorful. She uses a lot of different mediums, but this is watercolor. And it just reminds me of Matisse. Do you know what I'm saying?
It's really, really beautiful, and they have an anniversary. This is our anniversary, our 35th art auction, and this is your opportunity to make the bells ring. And that's the phones and a bell ringer. The number is 844-KVIE-ART. That's 844-584-3278. This is item 9A, Tulips and Fruit. We have a starting bid of $135. We're looking for a bid of $150. Tulips are beautiful. I think they're the flowers of flower. And this is a watercolor, correct?
Right, and it's kind of in the fauvist style, fauvism, which means, you know, representationally, the artist is trying to go for color more so than realism. And there was a movement in the early 1900s. It didn't last very long, maybe 10 years. And I think this is kind of like that style.
It's very beautiful. Fauvist, that's how you say it?
Yes, Fauvist. Yes.
1-844-584-3278. That's KVIE Art. Make the phones ring. This is a beautiful piece that you could go anywhere in your home or your office, right, Mary Ellen?
I think so. I think, you know, it'd be beautiful in a kitchen. It's a still life, so it's meant to channel kind of a moment in time. And I think Patricia does this very well. She's been an artist for a very long time, since she started teaching in 1961. So she's been at it a while, and it's a beautiful work of art that would be wonderful as a gift or for yourself or, you know.
Art is a great idea as a gift. It's colorful, it's inspirational, and you can inspire your community by supporting local art, by bidding on this piece and supporting public television at the same time. 584-3278, we have a starting bid of $135. We're looking for a bid of $150 for this beautiful, inspirational tulips. You can bring the garden into your home or even put it in a garden house if you have one of those. Beautiful tulips. What else can you tell us about the framing or the matting?
Well, it's a very interesting mat because it comes off of the paper. It's like in a shadow box a little bit, in the sense of you get the texture of what the artist had intended with the rough edge. But then there's also purple, there's a yellow mat, and then there's this kind of periwinkle mat, and then you have this beautiful green kind of rustic frame, and it's gorgeous.
So it's bringing all the colors together that you see in the painting out into the frame, onto your walls, if you are the lucky winner. Item 9A, tulips and fruit. And we're gonna go check in the phone bank. Let's see what's happening.
Yeah, that's fantastic. It just jumped up, I think, from like $95 to $200. Am I right, Cindy? No, I'm wrong. That's the tulips and fruit. $75 is where we're at now with white flowers.
We've got a starting bid already of 8F for white flowers. Remember, the donor value is $280, and boy, I'll tell you, Rob, I can barely see you. Are you there,
Yeah,
Rob?
It's actually beautiful. This is manzanita wood.
Yes.
The flowers are pieces of paper, and they almost, I'm told by Dee Neath, our art curator, that they're actually shavings of wood. And they're put together to make these beautiful blossoms. And this would be a forever flower arrangement in your home.
And if this was in my home, I'll tell you right now, the middle of the dining room.
That's what
table,
I thought.
It is a showstopper. If someone walks in the room and it's commanding, you want this in your home. The number's right there on your screen. It's 1-844-KVIE-ART. We've got a bid right now of $75, that's all. $280 is the donor value. Surely someone else can bid on this one.
Yeah, it's absolutely a gorgeous piece, and as Cindy said, it would look nice on a coffee table or maybe a bedside table as well. Let's go back over across the studio. Hey, Kelly.
Hey, Rob. They just had some flowers. Now we're with another flower. This is item 9B. It is Poppy by Emily Elders. This is a relief print, right, Mary Ellen?
Correct.
What can you tell us about that process?
Well, the process of relief printing is you have to think in reverse. So everything that is that the ink touches is raised, and everything that is negative space is carved away. So Emily is a printer. She's self-taught. And so this is one in a series of five, because it's very difficult to get, you have to lay each color down. So this is a four color print, and there's a little bit of, you know, as you can see, like spatter, because when she's pulling off the ink, sometimes it doesn't come out perfectly. In fact, most times it doesn't, and that's the beauty of relief printing.
And that's the beauty of relief printing, and the beauty of public television is when you call and make the phones ring. 844-584-3278, that's 844-KVIE-ART. This is 9B, Poppy. It has a retail value of $350. We have a high bid of $100. We're looking for a bid of $125. This is the state flower, I believe, Poppy's, and it's beautiful.
It is. I like the representational sun that she's done there, and then this kind of cup of gold, which is another word for saying the California poppy. And, you know, it's just a beautiful representation of what California is about. And it's also representational of the artist, Emily. She is just a bright ray of sunshine, if you know her. She has the most beautiful laugh. And I think that comes through in her art. She's very ebullient.
That's a great way to describe it. I love the lines too, with the very straight lines going down and then the arts just popping, the flower and the sun are popping out from those.
Right, it has a kind of an architectural feel, you know, because of the signature here. And then there's a beautiful framing aspect to this as well. Somebody, is it Choice?
It is Choice Framing.
Choice Framing, yes. They did a really nice job with bringing out the orange and the green on this. The blue kind of stands alone, but it's a really beautiful framing job as well.
It's a beautiful framing job. We're going to go over to the phone bank and see what's happening over there.
Hi, I'm Jessica. I'm here in the phone bank with Five Cities Democratic Club. They're all very busy on the phones. Be sure to pick up the phone and give us a call. We have a lot of pieces, great pieces up right now, and they're going fast. Someone just called for the White Flowers piece, and now it's closed. So don't miss out. Be sure to get in on the action. And now, back over to Kelly.
Thank you, Jessica. We're 9B. This is Poppy, a beautiful relief print. We have a high bid of $100. We're looking for a bid of $125, and that should be you calling 1-844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART. I hear some phones ringing, but not all of them. We need to hear more. Make this a bell ringer by ringing the bells. This is, again, 9B. This is Poppy, and it's a beautiful relief print. Where would this look beautiful, Mary Ellen?
It would look really nice anywhere, I think. I mean, you know, that's, I shouldn't say that, but, you know, it's just a beautiful piece because of the medium. You don't see relief prints that are this graphically beautiful that much. And Emily's been working for 14 years on this process, self-taught, and that's a lot of time, a lot of investment, and that's what you're buying, is her trial and error.
You're buying her trial and error, but you're also buying public television in your community by supporting local artists, by purchasing local art. We are now at item 9C. This is Spring Thaw by Alan Shannon. This is acrylic on canvas measuring 24 by 30. Framed by Choice Framing, it has a retail value of $600. And this is an impressive piece, Mary Ellen, just the size alone.
Yes, it's a pretty large piece. And it's just a feeling of what they call it, a freshet.
Oh, nice.
Right, yes. But I really like in this work the sky. It's very masterful in the sense of, like, if you get away from it, it almost looks like a photograph. I also like the trees. They remind me of Bob Ross's Happy Little Trees, you know, and I'm wondering if this artist was also somehow influenced, because he says that he's self-taught, and it's very hard to paint like this because it's wet on wet, and it has some motion, it has some really beautiful composition, overall a really nice work.
It reminds you of Bob Ross. I remember growing up watching Bob Ross on Saturday afternoons on public television, and it's inspirational. You never know where you're going to find your inspiration, but you know you can find it on public television. And you can make that happen again and again by calling 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART, and bidding on this piece. This is Spring Thaw. We've got a bid of $180. We're looking for a bid of $200. It's beautiful. I love waterfalls. It's one of my favorite things in nature, and you can put that in your living room or den.
Right, and the representation of water is as good as the water in the feng shui, where if you need to have something by your doorway that's water or something calming in your room, this is representational of that. And I think that he does a really nice job. He makes it look easy, and it's hard to do that. It's hard to paint this way because you're not quite sure what the medium is going to do for you.
It's also a window to the world, like public television is a window to the world. 844-584-3278, 844-KVIE-ART. This is art. We need you to make the phones ring. This is Spring Thaw. Thaw, the coldness of the phones not ringing. We're looking for a bid of $200 for item 9C, Spring Thaw. And we're going to go and check in the phone bank.
No, we only do this once a year, and wait a minute, if I turn this around, it'll work better.
The number's right there on your screen, 1-844-KVIE-ART is the easy way to remember it. It's 1-844, which again is toll-free number, 584-3278. The phone call doesn't cost you a thing. If you have questions, go ahead and ask our great phone bank talent. They'll be happy to answer your questions. But what we really want right now is for you to bid and buy fabulous, one-of-a-kind art from us here at KVIE Art Auction. Now let's go back to Kelly.
Thank you. We are on Spring Thaw. This is item 9C, and this is acrylic. Can you tell us about the challenges of working with acrylic, if there are any?
Yes, there's always a challenge when you're working with wet paint, because you have to be patient as an artist, and you know this because you're a pastel artist. You have to kind of wait for it to dry and see what's going to happen. In this work, with I think especially the blues and the greens, it depicts the water falling, and I think that would be a challenge, and he's mastered it here, so that's really nice.
And not just the water falling, but also that spray of when it hits the rocks, which is one of my favorite things, because it has that sound, and you can almost hear the sound when you look at the painting.
Right, and as the spring thaw happens, that's very hopeful as well.
It is hopeful. There's a bounty in this picture, and there's a bounty in public television when you support it. 844-KVIE-ART, that's 584-3278. This is item 9C, Spring Thaw. We have a high bid of $180. Let's make this a bid of $200. $200 for Spring Thaw and supporting KVIE Public Television, your window to the world, your window to art and adventure and exploration. And again, the colors just transport you, right, Mary Ellen?
They do. I think that we would be very well to have this anywhere in our house or an office, someplace where you need to just kind of sit and meditate for a moment and think about things thawing.
It's beautiful. Let's go over to the phone bank where they're thawing things out.
Yes, we are. And I just want to give a big shout out and a round of applause. If everyone could clap it up and give it up for our wonderful phone bank here today.
Yeah.
Five Cities Democratic Club, and we have some wonderful members of the California Highway Patrol, including this lovely lady right here, yes. And one of our wonderful pieces of art movers as well, Captain or Lieutenant?
What's that?
What's your title?
I'm a Lieutenant on the Captain's List.
Lieutenant on the Captain's List, Jill Dolce. Okay, so let's give a shout out to them as we did, and now we're going to shout out to the art. This is the way to keep arts alive on KVIE Public Television. We know it's a beautiful day. Please call your friends, tell them to come inside and watch the largest gathering of art in all of Northern California this weekend. As an art collector, you were doing the Manzanita flowers yourself. What do you love the most so far?
So far, what we've seen, mm-hmm. I love sculpture. I love the colors that we've been seeing, vibrant. In fact, I'm thinking it doesn't even do justice to see them, on the camera. In fact, if you want to go to kvie.org/art auction, you can see every one of these pieces on your computer.
As well as what's coming up.
Exactly, mm-hmm. exactly. And you might even decide ahead of time, hey, I want this one, and it'll tell you the time mm-hmm. and when to watch and when to bid. But the important thing is you've got to bid.
I think you brought up a very valid point. You need to look at the pieces that are coming up because we're here live till 10 o'clock tonight and tomorrow from noon to 10 again. That's kvie.org/art auction. Let's go back across the studio. Hey, Kelly.
Hey, Rob. We're with 9D. This is Water Lily Solitude. The number is 844-584-3278, 844-KVIE-ART. And I'm here with Mary Ellen. And Mary Ellen, what can you tell us about this beautiful Water Lily Solitude watercolor?
The artist is Teresa Steinbeck Garcia, and she has been very generous with KVIE over the years. This is a depiction of a water lily, which is a representational of rebirth and optimism. She captures it very well. It's just, she's a very accomplished artist teacher, and she's having a solo show in Davis next month. So this is a beautiful work and well worth a bid.
It's really beautiful and verdant and lush and just, and the phones are ringing and we need them to ring more. This is Water Lily Solitude. This is item 9D. It has a retail value of $560. It has a starting bid of $165. We're looking for a bid of $185 for Water Lily Solitude by Teresa Steinbeck Garcia, 17 by 24. Framed by Choice Framing, and watercolor is a difficult medium, but this looks so rich and lush.
She's a member of the California Watercolor Association. She takes her job seriously, of course. You know, she's very well practiced and has been doing it a number of years. Her website is, you go online and just look at her work, and it's gorgeous. She works in pastels as well. I think that people really respond to water lilies mainly because Monet made them so famous. But in other cultures, water lilies have special significance because they're rooted in soil, in water, and then they come up and flower. And it's kind of an interesting species.
How beautiful. And special significance is the framing oftentimes for a piece of art. And all of these pieces in this break are framed by choice framing. How does framing, especially this one, you know, impact the art?
Well, it can make or break something, actually. If you go to a really good framer, as choice is, the key is to make it feel as if the frame isn't there. It has to be subtle. Framing has been going on for many, many, many years. It's a very old trade, and people who know how to frame well bring out the best in the work, and I think that's occurred here.
It's really beautiful. Water Lily Solitude, item 90. The number is 584-3278. That's KVIE Art. We're looking for a bid of $185 for this beautiful, lush, meditative, very calming and relaxing, beautiful watercolor. Water Lily Solitude. Support the arts on KVIE Public Television by supporting local artists and getting a piece of local original art by this beautiful watercolorist. And watercolor is really hard because you, again, have to be patient, right, with the medium.
Have you tried it?
I have tried it. It's unforgiving because once you lay down color, it's there.
Right, and it's translucent in the sense of you cannot go back and erase. It's not like it's the end of the world, but, you know, when you get to a place where it's beautiful and you get to another layer, you have to kind of be careful and know what you're doing. And this technique looks like she uses a lot of wet. You know, there's different types of watercolor technique. You can do very dry, you can do very wet. But you don't know exactly how it's gonna work until it all kind of blends down and dries. Again, easier than it looks.
It is easier than it looks. And we're gonna go over to the phone bank where it's easier than it looks too.
Seeing the phone bank so active, filled with people. There you see Darla Givens back there, by the way, in the background. She's coming up in the next half hour as one of our art experts. But Cindy Sheldon, a longtime friend here of KVIE's, is also, by the way, happy birthday. Birthday
Thank
2 days
you.
2 days ago.
Don't say my age.
I won't, because I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
I would like to talk to you about your artistic flair. You're an artist yourself. And when you were just watching the lily pads, the Lily Solitude, that struck a chord with you. Why is that?
The colors were just magnificent, and the simplicity of it, I feel good when I see it. That's what art should really do to you when you look at something. If you love it and you feel good when you look at it, that's the kind of feeling you should have up in your home.
Yeah, that's why I buy art as pieces that I look at and love.
Yeah.
Oh, look. We have a bid now, $300 for Water Lily Solitude.
Perfect.
I want to back up and update you on 9C Spring Thaw. Is it $325 with a retail value of $600? And the next two pieces coming up in this half hour are stunning as well. Let's head back to Kelly.
Thanks, Rob. This is item 9E, Mighty Nature by Carol Hawkins. It is mixed media, measuring 12 by 12, framed by choice framing, retail value of $550. And we've got a starting bid of $165. We're looking for a bid of $185. Mary Ellen, when we were looking at the art earlier, you mentioned that this is mixed media. What is the mixed in the media?
Well, it's a torn paper collage. So in other words, the artist, what's her name? Carol Hawkins. She takes actual tissue paper that's made for this particular media, and then she uses that as paint. So all of this is three-dimensional. So it has kind of more of a three-dimensional feel. So the only thing that's painted is the sky and a little bit of these, like, sea spray. But the rest of it is torn paper.
It's absolutely beautiful. It's a coastal scene. I used to live near the coast in San Francisco. It's got that sound. You can hear the ocean when you look at the paper, the painting, and you've got the texture. This is Mighty Nature. It is a mighty little painting, measuring 12 by 12, framed by Choice Framing, 9E. The number is 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART. Bring the coast into your home or take it to, give it to a friend. Art is a great gift, isn't it, Mary Ellen?
It is, and this piece really photographs very nicely because of the three-dimensionality of it. Carol says that she likes to use the paper as a brush stroke. So, you know, that's a different way of thinking as well. It's not, and she wraps it all the way around. So it comes out of the frame in the sense of it has some motion, obviously, because she's doing the C, but it also, it's just different than the painting. When you look at it up close, you can see it, the waves have more energy to them almost.
It seems like there's an intimacy involved too with the artist and the medium because they're manipulating it a little bit more.
Right.
Which kind of comes through.
And again, it's one of those mediums that once you master it, you become the person who can do that. And it's one of a kind. It's your vision because it's not just flat oil, flat acrylic, photography. This is, mixed media can be somewhat more challenging. Probably waste a lot more materials.
You can be the person who masters supporting public television when you call 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART, and we're going to go check in with the phone bank.
There you see our call letters shining brightly. KVIE. The V and the I are the Roman numerals for six, and the E stands for education. And right now, every call that you make stands up for the arts. We are your front row seat to the arts. We are your entertainment to the world right here on PBS, and we take that very proudly.
I was thinking you should have a TV show, Rob on the Road.
I do. You
yes.
should too.
Yes, I should.
Sheldon on the Street.
And if you're sitting there on the fence, get off the fence. You can get this art selection online at kvie.org/art auction. You can see what's on now, what's coming up. We're only doing this for 3 days. After tomorrow, we're done. So now let's go back to Kelly.
Thanks, guys. We are over here, Mighty Nature. You be the mighty bidder by calling 844-584-3278. This is a beautiful piece. It's a coastal piece. It's mixed media. And it's got a very tactile frame along with it, too.
Right. And it's kind of a square composition. So that's interesting. I think, again, it could go by a door, someplace where there needs to be a water feature. To bring in good energy that comes in and out. And it's also very meditative, and the beautiful purples and the blues and the greens. She did a masterful job of this.
It's a masterful job. It's another window to the world, like public television. We are moving on to item 9F. This is Dark Matter by Marcia Ballard. It is acrylic on paper measuring 22 by 28. Again, framed by Choice Framing with a retail value of $500. The number is 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART. And Mary Ellen, this is such a colorful piece. I love it.
Right, and I love that it's in this group because it's very abstract and it's different than all of the others, landscapes and figuratives. I'm reminded of the KVIE video that starts out each hour with Leonard Nimoy and the Star Trek theme. And I think that the painter here is, the artist is trying to kind of channel the dark matter in the universe and the maybe a black hole, but obviously color in the black hole. So it's a gorgeous piece.
It's a gorgeous piece. It is acrylic on paper, and it looks like, is this what you call floating in the frame, the way it's framed?
Right. The framer takes some archival tape and then just kind of lightly, like in sewing, just baste it down so that it's able to stay put, and then builds a box frame so that it gives it room to just kind of float. And then that, for this piece, it's really nice because of this matte, which brings out this kind of teal color. And it's just really a very nice piece.
It's very energetic, but it's also very soulful and very soothing to look at and inspiring because you're like, where is this going? I want to go there. Dark Matter, 9F. It has a starting bid of 150. We're looking for a bid of 175. 175, it's abstract. It could be the cosmos. It could be your window into the world. The cosmos, like supporting public television by supporting this piece. You're supporting programs like NOVA and Nature and also arts programming throughout the year. 844-584-3278. And is this acrylic on paper? Again, is that a fast drying medium, Mary Ellen?
It can be faster than oil, but I think Marcia Ballard is the artist in this. In this piece, she says that her process is that she starts to think linearly with one side of her brain, and she gets all of her paints out and sketches it and everything. And then, I can't remember which side it is, she switches to the other, more creative side and just lets go. And she channels where it's going. And in the abstract of this, you can see that where, you know, she was in the zone. She channeled something and it came out like this, and it works.
We need to be in the zone by Get the Auction Started on this piece with a bid of $150, and we're going to go over to the phone bank.
This stunning piece by Carol Hawkins has so much paint on it that as I look at it, it's actually three-dimensional. So it makes you feel the waves and the texture, and it's phenomenal. Right now, we've got a bid of only $165 on Mighty Nature. This is 9E, and the donor value is $550. It's also framed very beautifully. The 3D frame is put onto a backing and then the frame on the side of it. It's stunning, and I bet it would look fabulous in your home. Stay tuned because there's more art coming up in the next half hour in the KVIE Art Auction.
Bidding on items in the art auction is quick and easy to do. First, explore the collection online at kvie.org/art auction. Or keep your television tuned to KVIE. When a piece of art catches your eye, call 1-844-KVIE-ART and a volunteer will assist you. KVIE accepts all major credit cards for your art purchase, and a member of our accounting team will confirm your payment within 5 minutes of item sale. Thank you for being part of the KVIE Art Auction and for making art a part of your home today.
Stay tuned for Still Life and Landscapes, coming up next on the KVIE Art Auction. Juried by Carrie Kelly, this category features still life and non-California landscapes in all media. View all of the art featured in this year's auction at kvie.org/art auction.
Hello again, I'm Kelly Rains, and we're back for another exciting half hour of the Art Auction featuring still life and landscape works. And now, here's an overview of the art that will be up for bid during the next half hour. First item, 10A, is Oregon Wilderness by Pat Scott. This is oil on canvas measuring 24 by 18. It is artist framed. Retail value is $300. Item 10B is Let There Be Light by Robert Tonjes. This is acrylic on board measuring 32 by 44. It is artist framed with a retail value of $800. Item 10C is Sailboat Harbor by John Paul. This is oil on canvas measuring 16 by 20. It is artist framed with a retail value of $400. Item 10D is Joy by Sue Chapman. This is acrylic on paper measuring 20 by 20. It is artist framed with a retail value of $480. Item 10E is Quiet Contemplation by Carol Mendez. This is acrylic on canvas measuring 18 by 24. It is artist framed with a retail value of $250. And item 10F is Grand Tetons Through the Morning Mist by Jana Markovici. This is pastels measuring 16 by 20. It is artist framed with a retail value of $250. During this break, we are pleased to be joined again by award-winning artist Mary Ellen Lane, who is a longtime volunteer and auction supporter. Thanks so much for being here, Mary Ellen.
My pleasure, Kelly.
I'm having fun with you. This
yes,
is fun.
Yes, we are.
So let's have some fun with this piece. This is Oregon Wilderness 10A by Pat Scott. This is got a retail value of $300. We have a starting bid of $90. We're looking for a bid of $100 just to get the auction started. What can you tell us about this painting?
It's oil, and oil's a difficult medium, and this artist has obviously got a command of it. This is a photo taken while on a camping trip in Oregon, and so the artist decided, Pat Scott decided to kind of freeze this moment in time. It's one of a series that the artist is, she wants to bring some outdoors inside.
It's really beautiful. You can bring the outdoors inside, but like a lot of these pieces this hour, it is a window to the world. Like public television is a window to the world. When you support local artists, you're supporting those windows with local programming like Rob on the Road, Viewfinders, Studio Sacramento, and KVIE Arts Showcase. This is item 10A, Oregon Wilderness by Pat Scott, oil and canvas. We are looking for a bid of $100 just to get the auction started, make the phones ring on this lush, beautifully framed piece, Mary Ellen. Tell us about the framing with the piece.
The artist framed this, and it's a really beautiful, ornate frame, and it's kind of going back to the old school style of framing, which a lot of museums are doing now, where they're going back to original types of frames for the period. This is a very classic treatment of oil, and I think the frame works nicely with it.
It looks really nice, and what works nicely with public television is when you make the phones ring. 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART, aptly named. This is Oregon Wilderness. We're looking for a bid of $100. Make the phones ring. Don't lose out on this beautiful piece. And we're going to go check in with the phone bank. What's going on over there?
Marcia Ballard. Hi, I'm here in the phone bank with Dark Matter number 9F. I love this piece. It's by Marcia Ballard. She's a longtime contributor. This was done, was framed graciously by Choice Framing. I love what they did with it. The white with the turquoise has that kind of nice beachy feeling. What a great piece to brighten up your home. Right now, I only need a bid of $150. So call in and let's go back to my friend Kelly.
Thank you, Dee. We are looking for a bid. We've got a bid of $160 now on this. Let's go for a bid of $175 for Oregon Wilderness. Item 10A, the phone number is 844-584-3278. 844-KVIE-ART. I love that phone number. And I love this piece with the beautiful greens. It's very lush and full of life and water. I love water in paintings.
And the artist, Pat, says that don't take to art too seriously. She likes to have fun, likes to enjoy her art with her friends, and it's a really nice way of expressing oneself creatively by painting.
It's beautiful. And you can express yourself by supporting public television, and that supports the community with great local programs. And you get a lovely piece of local art by a local artist. This is Pat Scott's Oregon Wilderness. We've got a bid of $185. We're looking for a bid of $200. $200 to get a window to the world and this beautiful, beautiful oil painting, Oregon Wilderness. And it measures 24 by 18, so this is a substantial size.
It's a nice commanding work of art, and it takes a while to do oil. It takes a while for oil to dry. So I think that this is a really good buy. It would be a very nice piece to bid on and, you know, have in your home.
It's beautiful. You have to be patient to paint this, but you can't be patient to call because the time is of the essence to make that call. 844-KVIE-ART. That's 844-584-3278. We're moving on to item 10B, and this is Let There Be Light by Robert Tonjes. It is acrylic on board measuring 32 by 44. Again, artist framed. And this is a retail value of $800. And this is a beautifully nice, big, colorful piece, Mary Ellen. What can you tell us?
It's on glass, and there's a French name for it that I cannot pronounce. But the basis of it is, again, is it's kind of a relief idea where the artist paints on glass and then has to turn it around so that they can be looked through. And so you have to frame it so that the light hits it, and then you can see all of these different colors. But this actual canvas is glass. So that gives it this luminescent quality, and it's been a practice that's been happening for, you know, centuries.
It's beautiful. It's kind of like through the looking glass, beautiful art through the looking glass of public television. You get so much arts programming on KVIE. And look at the sky. It's moving. It's inspirational. It's probably my favorite part of the day, which is dusk when the sky is changing.
And glass can be a very different medium in that it gives off a luminescence. It's like a gilded effect. In fact, in a lot of other countries, like in India, people are using there's a resurgence for this type of technique where they're using gold because it really makes it jump off of the canvas or the glass. And it's a really large, commanding piece, and Robert has been doing this work for 17 years. So I think he's perfected it, don't you?
I think he's perfected it quite a bit. And speaking of perfection, let's check in with Dee. Dee?
Coming to me. I am here in the phone bank, and it's a busy place. I want to remind everybody, these pieces are up from 5 to 10 minutes. Again, just heard somebody call and want to bid on a piece that was already closed. So the only way you're going to get that work is to call 1-844-584-3278. If you're not registered to bid, make sure to call in a few minutes early so we can get you registered. Let's go back and look at these great landscapes. I love this section.
Congratulations.
Let There Be Light. This is such an important piece. This is a gorgeously big piece. I could see it over my fireplace. If I wasn't here right now, I'd probably be on the phone like you should be. 844-584-3278. Let There Be Light, Mary Ellen.
Well, the artist says that he, like we were talking about the zone earlier, he said that this painting was kind of a spiritual revelation for him. So, you know, when you get immersed in your process, especially over it's a long period of time, there is a place you go to kind of get a channel into the window on the world that you're talking about. And he's captured this here with the trees and the water and especially the sky. It's just, we've seen some of these skies recently in Northern California, and it's nice that artists can capture them.
It is really nice, and you can capture this beautiful art. 584-3278, that's 844-584-3278. This is Let There Be Light, item 10B. It is a retail value of $800. We've got a bid of $200. We're looking for a bid of $225. $225, this is one of those pieces and locales, like after you've taken a long hike, and the reward is you get to sit down and look at the trees and the beautiful sky.
And just, yes, take it in and say, this is what life's all about.
This is what life's all about, gathering some memories, and along with that is art. And PBS, for many of us, is what life is all about, and it is for you too and your family and the community. 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART. Item 10B, Let There Be Light. You be the light. Make the phones ring. We have a bid of $200. We're looking for a bid of $225. We are moving on to item 10C. It is Sailboat Harbor by John Paul. It is oil on canvas measuring 16 by 20. It is artist framed with a retail value of $400. And this is such a sweet little piece, Mary Ellen. Tell us about it.
The artist is very serious with oil. In his statements, he talks about waiting for it to dry and waiting for it to come up and having patience and being very careful about his drawings. And in this sense, you can really, it really comes through in this work because of these boats and the landscape. And it is just like looking out the window at a marina to me, but it'd be any place or time, don't you think?
Yes, it can. It's really elegant. It's very peaceful. I want to go there. I want to see the sailboats and the harbor. This is item 10C. It is Sailboat Harbor. It is a retail value of $400. We have a starting bid of $120. We have a bid of $125. Let's give a bid of $150 by making the phones ring. They're ringing a little bit, but not as much as they should be. 584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART. And what else can you tell us about this artist or his process?
Well, it was interesting to me in his notes, he said that do not be swayed by the critics. In other words, like I paint because I want to paint, and I don't care too much about what other people think of it. And I guess that spoke to me because as an artist, that's very important. And I think that he translates that well because there's a carefree feel to this, but there's also a very classical sense of the boats on the lake. Like, this could be Donner Lake. It could be a lake in New York. It could be a lake in Michigan. There's a timelessness to this piece that I really, really think is masterful.
Beautiful. It could be Lake Tahoe, which is in just in our backyard. Gorgeous piece. You can feel the water, the sweet little sailboats on the harbor. This is item 10C. It is aptly named Sailboat Harbor. We've got a bid of $275. Let's get a bid of $300. $300 on this beautiful afternoon to have this beautiful piece of art. And we're going to go over and check in with Dee in the phone bank. Dee?
I am standing here with Tongass's piece 10B, Let There Be Light. It's a retail of $800. We have a current bid of $200. I love this piece. If you don't have a beautiful window in your office, here's your window on the world. What a great way to give yourself a little relaxation in the afternoon to sit there and meditate on such a beautiful piece and help KVIE at the same time. I've got $200. I want to hear $250. This piece is framed. It's ready to go. It's got a retail of $800. So it's already a good price, but let's get a better price for KVIE. And let's go back out to my friend Mary Ellen.
I am here with Mary Ellen. Thank you for being here on this afternoon. We are with item 10C. This is Sailboat Harbor. It has a retail value of $400. We've got a bid of $400. Let's get a bid of $425. We've got a bid of $425. Let's get a bid of $450. This is item 10C, Sailboat Harbor. This is a bell ringer. That is the most beautiful sound in this studio, right? And you can make that sound happen all the time on every piece of art, but this is the art we're talking about right now, and there's not a lot of time. 844-KVIE Art. Again, beautiful sailboats on the harbor, peaceful. What else do you love about this piece?
I just love this. I mean, sometimes you don't have words for why you love a piece of art, and I kind of don't. It just transports me to wanting to be on a boat, you know, especially on a day like today.
It's beautiful, and we're gonna go over to see Cindy in the phone bank. Cindy?
We need those phones to ring, and we need you to get up and go to the phone and dial the number on your screen, 1-844-584-3278. We have a great phone bank. They are the CHP and also the Five Cities Democratic Club who gave their afternoons, and luckily a lot of them are on the phone right now, but don't let that stop you because we've got more people. We've got as many as it'll take to answer the phone. We do this once a year, and we need to hear from you, and thank you so much for watching us today. Now, Kelly?
Thank you, Cindy. We are with item 10D. This is Joy, and all the letters are capital, and I love that because it's a capital letter kind of joy. It's got a retail value of $480. It's got a high bid right now of $140. Let's get a bid of $175. $175 for Joy. Joy, people. 844-584-3278. Mary Ellen, tell us about Joy.
The artist is Sue Chapman. She's joyful in her painting. The interesting work here is it looks like a watercolor, but it's actually acrylic. So she's laying it on really thinly, almost in the sense of, like, this looks graphic to me in the sense of, like, Maxfield Parrish or Art Nouveau. It's a really California scene, don't you think, Kelly?
It does. It reminds me of orchards or a lot of the beautiful forests that we have in our region. 844-584-3279. We have beautiful artists in our region, too, that goes along with our public television, because you see beautiful art on that, too. 844-584-3278. This is Joy. We've got a bid of $175. We're looking for a bid of $200. $200 for some joy on a Saturday afternoon. You're creating more joy by supporting public television and all of the great programming. We've got one. We've got $175. Let's get to $200 on Joy. This is item 10D. There are people dancing in the studios. We need more music to keep the dancing going, and the music is the phones ringing. What else can you tell us about the? It's a substantial mat around this beautiful painting.
Right, it's a square piece of art, which is another kind of anomaly. Most people paint either rectangularly or, but I'm still really enamored of her process because she uses very translucent acrylic. and it gives it a very, again, a graphic feel. This tree is, it's just so subtly done, and the colors are so well blended. And don't you feel like you could just kind of be sitting under it and dreaming? And again, a meditative work of art that would look really nice in any part of your home or office.
I understand the contemporary juror for the show was very smitten with this piece. I'm very smitten with this piece. I want to sit under that tree and drink wine or watch my knees climb the tree. And let's get the phones ringing for some joy. This is item 10D. It is a very joyful piece. We've got a bit of $275. We're looking for a bit of $300. $300 for joy. I know I keep saying it, but it is joyful. And you bring joy to the community and your family by supporting public television when you support local artists. And joy, retail value of $480. We're looking for a bit of $300. And we're going to go check in with the phone bank.
It's getting really exciting here. This is exactly what we want to see. This is an auction. It's a live auction. This is not taped. It's not recorded. It's happening right now. Pieces are coming on, and in just moments, they're being bid on and won. So won't you be one of them? We want to hear more phones ringing. All you need to do to make the phones ring is call that number. It's on your screen. Easy to remember. 1-844-KVIE. Art, A-R-T, simple, easy peasy. Now let's go back to Kelly.
Thank you. We are now on item 10E, quiet contemplation. And I love the title, but we don't want any quiet contemplation in the studio or for you at home when you're thinking about buying some art. 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART. We've got a starting bid of $75. Let's get a bit of $100. Mary Ellen, when I first saw this painting, I knew exactly where it was. And tell us about that.
The artist is Carol Mendez, and every Californian has a San Francisco view in their mind and wanted to capture that. So this is, let me get it exactly right, a quiet spot in Lafayette Park looking down Octavia Street toward Fort Mason in the Bay. So that's where this is, and the artist has captured that moment in time with this place.
It's beautiful. I used to live in San Francisco, and I remember hiking up the very, very high streets to get to this park. And then your reward is you turn around, you've got these stunning views, and the artist has expertly captured it in this painting.
I really like the figure of the everyman sitting with his cup of coffee there, or his soda, I don't know. And just kind of, you can imagine what he or she is feeling when looking down across the bay and, you know, the clouds. It's just so classic. And the perspective is also very nice. Another thing that's hard to achieve. I think the artist has done a very fine job here.
We're imagining what he's feeling in the painting, but I'm imagining what you're feeling at home when you look at this and you love it. And the phone number is 844-584-3278. It's a retail value of $250. We're looking for a bid of $100. We've got a bid of $75, but we want a bid of $100 right now for a little piece of San Francisco to hang on your wall so you can quietly contemplate your next adventure, because this is another window to the world, like public television. And we're going to go check in with Dee. Dee, what's going on?
Yeah. I've got A, C, and D are bell ringers right now. The bidding is hot and heavy. The phones are full. So if you want to bid on any of these pieces, you got to call really quickly because there's another bell ringer there. I'm not going to recap them, but if you're interested in any of the pieces you've just seen, you got to call now. They go really fast. The number is 1-844-584-3278. We've got a crazy auction going on. Let's go back and take another look at that piece with Kelly and Mary Ellen.
Quiet contemplation. Again, that's not what we want for you at home. We don't want that in the studio. We want joyful action instead of quiet contemplation. But this is, put a great home in your home. And this is a beautiful piece in San Francisco in our region. Item 10E, we're looking for a bid of $100. Mary Ellen, what else do you love about this piece?
Well, I think if you are from San Francisco and you have relocated to our region, this would be a really nice remembrance of where you're from, or if you have people that are in San Francisco and you kind of want to pay homage to them in your home, this is your piece, you know, and I think it's a really nice work of art. And again, the perspective is, and the colors, it could be spring, it could be fall, summer, you know, it's very versatile work.
It's beautiful. I mentioned before, when I saw this, I knew exactly where it was. So the artist has expertly captured this location in San Francisco, in Northern California, in our own home. This is your public television station in your home, and support it by supporting this local art and this artist. We've got a bid of 125. Let's get a bid of 150 for item 10E. We are moving on to item 10F. This is Grand Tetons Through the Morning Mist by Gianna Marcovici. This is pastels measuring 16 by 20. It is artist framed with a retail value of $250. The phone number is 844-584-3278. That's 844-KDIE-ART. And Mary Ellen, I absolutely love this piece. I'm partial because it is pastels, but it's beautifully done. What can you tell us?
Well, it's in Wyoming, the Grand Tetons Through the Morning Mist. The artist is a very accomplished pastel artist, obviously. And the thing about pastel, as you know, Kelly, is it becomes luminescent. And in this case, you can really see that. You have the Grand Tetons rising in the mist. The artist took a picture of this as floating down the Snake River in Wyoming, and then came back to the studio and translated into pastel.
It's absolutely beautiful. You can translate support of public television by supporting this local artist and bidding on item 10F. That is Grand Tetons Through the Morning Mist. It has a starting bid of $75. Let's get a bid of $100 on this beautiful, elegant, sweet, and very expertly done pastel piece, which is gorgeously framed too.
It's a pastel connotes pastel, like the colors of that to me. And I think the colors of this autumn are especially poignant right now because we're approaching autumn here, and there is a serenity in this landscape that really comes through, just masterfully done by this artist.
There is a serenity and like quiet contemplation. Put the serenity on your walls, but don't have it right now. Call the phone number, 844-584-3278. And let's check in with the phone bank where those phones are.
I am here with my friend Cindy Sheldon, also a contributing artist to this year's KVIE Art Auction. And she drove all the way up from San Francisco today. So let's talk about this piece.
I did. And you know, I recognize this instantly because it looks like a listing I had on Telegraph Hill. This is so iconic San Francisco. And who doesn't love taking a day trip or a day drive to San Francisco on a beautiful day? Fog's rolled out. This gentleman is just contemplating the view and just having a great relaxing time. And that's what art to me is for, is to make you feel a certain way. And this feels fantastic.
It's a great big piece. Right now we've got a bid of $225. You can take it home. Give me a bid of $250. You do that by calling 844-584-3278. And like I said, this whole section's going really fast. So let's go back to Kelly and Mary Ellen.
Thank you. We are having a lot of bell ringers. Let's make this one a bell ringer, too. We're looking for a bid of $100 for Grand Tetons Through the Morning Mist, item 10F. And the Grand Tetons are in Wyoming, correct?
Correct, yes. I've never been there either, but have you been there?
I haven't been there, but I feel like I'm there right now when I see the painting.
I know, and I've always wanted to go. And I think that in some ways, I don't have to because I can see it through this. And that's the beauty of art, is that you can, if you can't get there, you can at least have it on your wall.
Yeah, if we can't get there, or if we're going somewhere else and we're flying over it, we don't have to do that anymore. We can put it in our living room, in our den, in our kitchen. Or you can give it to a friend who loves the Tetons, who has been there, a nice little remembrance piece. That phone number, and the phones are ringing, but they need to ring a little bit more, 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART. And it's got a retail value of $250. We've got a bid of $150. Let's get a bid of $175. Let's make it a bell ringer. We're getting close to doing that. Make the cacophony of the phones even louder. Grand Tetons Through the Morning Mist. And it you keep mentioning serenity. It is really serene. I love water and nature scenes.
Absolutely beautiful, yes.
And it's hard to do water in any medium, just and it's reflecting in this beautiful painting, right?
It does. It just comes right out of the frame almost.
It's beautiful. 844-584-3278, 844-KVIE Art. We've got a bid of $200, and let's go check in with the phone bank.
You know, in moments, we are going to wrap up this set. I know you think they're going to stay on your TV forever. They're not. You've got to pick up the phone right now and make that call to us here at KVIE Art Auction, 1-844-584-3278. Don't let somebody else get your piece. If it would look great in your house, it's yours. Call the number on your screen, make the best bid, win the piece, and you can actually come down to the studio later on today and pick it up and literally have it hanging in your home. 1-844-KVIE Art. Now back to Kelly.
I'm really excited because to hear that noise, that means this is a bell ringer. So I think we've had almost all bell ringers this period. This is 10F Grand Teton through the Morning Mist. But the bell ringing doesn't mean you have to stop bidding on this. It doesn't mean it's gone away until it has gone away. We're looking for a bid of $300. This is item 10F Grand Teton through the Morning Mist. 844-584-3278. That's 844-KVIE-ART for this beautiful pastel piece. And stay tuned because there's more art coming up in the next half hour in the KVIE Art Auction.